Hello, and welcome to Inequalities Part 2. In this video, you'll learn what symbols to use when you want to show that one value is less than or equal to another, or that one value is greater than or equal to another. Before you watch this video, be sure that you have watched the video called Inequalities 1. Then come back to this one. You already know that in math, we often try to find the exact answer to a problem or equation. But you learned in Inequalities Part 1 that sometimes two values are not equal, and they are represented by the symbols for greater than and less than, or not equal to. Sometimes a number can be less than or equal to another value. For example, if you have 6 candies, but you have a hole in your pocket, how many candies do you have left? The number of candies you have is less than or equal to 6. It's possible that you lost some candies out of that hole in your pocket. But it's also possible that you didn't lose any. So you may still have 6 in your pocket. The symbol for less than or equal to is a combination of the less than sign with the equal sign below it. Sometimes a number can be greater than or equal to another value. For example, if you start with 6 candies in your pocket, and your friend has some candy too, but he may or may not share them with you, how many candies do you have? The number of candies you have is greater than or equal to 6. You have 6 for sure because they're yours, and your friend might share some of his with you. If he does, then you'll have more or greater than 6 candies. The symbol for greater than or equal to is a combination of the greater than sign and the equal sign right below it. Now, sometimes you can use a combination of these symbols in one equation. Let's look at what I mean. You ask your brother to guess how many candies and you give him a hint. You tell him that the number of candies you have in your pocket is a number between 4 and 9. In other words, you have more than 4 candies, but less than 9. The answers can be 5, 6, 7, or 8, because they are all numbers between 4 and 9, or greater than 4 and less than 9. Why aren't 4 and 9 part of the answers? If you had given your brother this hint, the number of candies you have in your pocket is greater than or equal to 4 and less than or equal to 9, then 4 and 9 would be good answers too. When reading an expression such as this one with multiple inequalities, we don't read it left to right. Instead, we read it from the middle first, then left, then right. So we say the number of candles is greater than or equal to, notice the large mouth opening towards candles, and less than or equal to 9. By the way, your friend is a good friend, and you actually have 8 candies in your pocket. So if your brother guessed 8, then he was correct. Hooray! You now know 2 more inequality symbols, and that you can show multiple inequalities in one equation. If you want more practice working with these inequality symbols, visit our online games and quizzes. Have fun, and remember to always be clever. Hey!